Acne is a very common skin condition and it usually starts in the teenage years, but it's a disease of adulthood, so it can affect people into their 20s, 30s, 40s or sometimes beyond. It usually affects the face but can also affect the back and the chest. Acne occurs when hormones affect the pilosebaceous unit. This is the part of the skin where you have a grease-secreting gland in association with a hair follicle. What you get is a build-up of secretions within the follicle that then becomes inflamed. The symptoms and signs of acne include blackheads, what we would call comedones, also little inflammatory bumps in the skin or papules, and sometimes yellowheads or pustules. The face is the most common area to be affected by acne, but also the upper back and chest can be commonly affected. When the acne's been untreated for a period of time, there'll tend to be a lot of inflammation in the skin, which can take a long time to settle down, and also scarring, which can be permanent. The treatment for acne really depends on the severity and the type of acne that you're dealing with. In predominantly blackhead or comedonal acne, you would usually be looking at topical preparations onto the skin to try and unclog the pores and improve the appearance of the comedones. For more inflammatory acne, where there are little inflamed bumps and papules in the skin, you'd need to look at a specific anti-inflammatory treatment for this. Now, this could be something you use topically on the skin, for example, a variety of different antibiotics, or sometimes in more severe cases, we would be looking at systemic treatment, tablet treatment with oral antibiotics. The way that these work is not just to kill bacteria that are in the skin, but more to have an anti-inflammatory effect and dampen down the inflammation that's going on causing the papules. Sometimes for more severe cases of acne that haven't responded to other treatments or that are giving problems with scarring, we'd consider treatment with isotretinoin. Isotretinoin needs to be prescribed by a dermatologist. There are a number of considerations that we'd need to think about before prescribing isotretinoin. Specifically, you would need to have a blood test before starting and then once you're on treatment. Another consideration is that you mustn't become pregnant whilst you're taking isotretinoin because there is a risk of severe birth defects. For this reason, if you're sexually active, your dermatologist will ask you to use two forms of effective contraception for the duration of treatment and for 2 months after stopping it. It has no effect on your fertility or any problems once you've discontinued it for at least 2 months. A third consideration is that this may not be a suitable treatment for you if you have a tendency to depression. Sometimes people use laser or light therapy for their acne. This can diminish the inflammation in the skin, but the relief it brings is usually temporary.